Good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, depending on when you are watching me. It is time for our maths meeting, and I do love maths, and I hope that you love maths too. We are going to start with some unicorn tiles. 10 tile, just one, and 5 tile. So have a think, what number do you think you are looking at? All together. And if you know that it's 14, then you will be absolutely right, and you will be able to think about how you would write that as a numeral. So the 10 we would write like that, but we've got the 5 ones. So we take away that 0 and we add the 5. That's how we come to write the numeral 15. 10 looks like this, and 5 ones looks like that. So there we are, that's how we write 15. We're going to look at halving. I have put up 2 numicon tiles, they're both 4s, and we're going to start by looking at what happens if we just draw a line down the middle. There we are. So have we got the same number on both sides? Because if we have, it means we've halved 4. 1, 2 on the left, 1, 2 on the right, we have halved 4, and it is 2. Half of 4 is 2. Let's halve this in the other direction. This is going to be a horizontal divide. Let's see if we can get it to happen. Oh, sorry, folks. There we are. 4 has been divided. So we've got 2 at the top and 2 circles at the bottom. So we're going to say that is a half because 2 and 2 make 4. Half of 4 is 2. Right, now we're looking at 2 10 tiles. We're going to halve the first one, we're going to halve it vertically. So we're going to halve it down the middle from top to bottom. I'm going to count how many I've got on both sides of that red line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So I have to have 5 on the other side if I've halved this 10 tile. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have halved 10. Going from top to bottom, and we've got 5 on each side. So half of 10 is 5. Next, we're going to look at the other 10 tile, but this time we're going to put a red line through horizontally from right to left or left to right. So here we go, there it is. And let's see if we've halved it again. Top row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bottom row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, terrific. So half of 10 is 5. But I can show you with 2 more numicon tiles that we can do that slightly differently. We've got the 5 there and the 5 there. So that is another way of looking at half of 10. Right, which bottle contains the least liquid? We're talking about capacity. We've got a bottle containing red liquid, a bottle containing blue, and a bottle containing green. Which one has the least liquid in it? The middle one. The middle one with the blue liquid has got the least. Which one's got the most? The bottle with the green liquid. And the bottle in on the left with the red liquid is what? Is it completely full? Is it completely empty? Or is it half full? It's half full. Next, we're going to look at those shapes again. And we are going to see this time if we can spot the cylinder. And I'd like you to remember that a cylinder has a circle, a circular top, a circular base, and one continuous curved surface, but no apex, no vertices. So, did you spot the Pringles tin? That's your cylinder. How about cubes? Can you spot a cube? I've seen three. There's one. There's another. And there's the third one. All of those 3D shapes are cubes. What next? Just a quick flash there. Subitizing. What number of green dots did you see? Hopefully four. Now for our 10 frames. Ready to count? 1, 2, 3 purple dots, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14. So 10 fingers for that bottom 10 frame and 4 for the top. 10 and 4 together comes to 14. So we've got 14 purple dots. If we add the empty squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we know that 14 and 6 must equal 20. Hooray, well done if you thought that. The big yellow dot, it's getting bigger all the time. What square is that yellow dot in? I'm going to start at the first and go along. First, second. I think it's the fifth. I hope you did too. Now, finally, we're on solve the riddle. This is a new one. The riddle has to be solved. You are going to work out what number I have been thinking about here. It says, I am a one-digit number. Well, as you can see at the bottom, we've got two rows from 1 to 20. Can you see where the two-digit numbers are? 10 is a two-digit number, so that's no good, because this number we're thinking of is a one-digit number. So it can't be 10, or 11, or 12, or 13, or 14, or 15, or 16, or 17, or 18, or 19, or 20, because those numerals have two digits. So now we're down to the numbers that are only one digit. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right, the next clue to the riddle. I am bigger than 4. Well, is 1 bigger than 4? No. Is 2 bigger than 4? No, so they can't be the number we're looking for. Is 3 bigger than 4? 3 is less than 4. Is 4 bigger than 4? No. I am bigger than 4, but smaller than 9, so it can't be 9. So look at what we've got left. We've worked out that it can only be 5, 6, 7, or 8. Next clue. You can halve me into two groups of 3. Okay, two groups of 3. That's one group of 3, and that's another group of 3. So those are two halves of what number? Have you worked it out? What do you think the number we're looking for is? I think it's 6. If you thought it was 6 too, then well done. You've solved the riddle, and that's the first time you've done that. So next time I'm going to make it just as challenging, but I'm going to see if you can work it out for yourselves. The way to do it is to take out the numbers you know it can't be and carry on until you are down to just a few and the one last clue. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you again soon. Goodbye for now.